According to the NAPAC District Woman MP Faith Nakut, by 8th July, NAPAC District had registered 46 deaths to starvation, with 2,181 households in fear of death over the same due to the dire state of famine that is ravaging Karamoja sub-region. Nakut and other legislators from Karamoja have come out to cry to the world to move fast and rescue the people of Karamoja before the death toll widens.
During recess, I managed to visit, together with my colleagues, we moved in the region of Karamoja to mobilize our people for peace. But during that tour, we got many people at the verge of starvation. In my district, I visited some sub-counties, some parishes like Nagule Angolol. I found when they had just buried a family, a whole family died because they had no food. So I came back really heartbroken because I never imagined we would get to this level. I knew we would normally face disasters, but I never imagined that we would be in a level where people die because they are lacking food.
I want all of us to pray for Karamoja and stand with the people of Karamoja. The situation in Karamoja is not really good. People are dying in silence. There are a lot of challenges that Karamoja is undergoing now in this 21st century. Because this is what we witnessed in 1980s, in 1979, 1980s, 1985. When you go to Karamoja right now, there are a lot of issues that are happening in Karamoja. Insecurity is eating up Karamoja. The disarmament is going on in Karamoja. The hunger situation is invading Karamoja. The weather situation is not also good in Karamoja. And so many other problems.
Nakut, who broke down while addressing a press conference at Parliament, noted that they have depleted their salary as MPs to buy food for the most affected households due to slow response by the government.
The needs are so immense. I have tried even exhausting salary. It has not even reached 0.001% of the need. So I need support, seriously. Now, it has to happen now. If you care about humanity and you're watching and listening, please, it's time to take action. We can explain other things, not this one.
Karamoja MPs attribute the current famine to gross insecurity in the region that disabled families from settling for cultivation and rustling that left farmers with no animals on top of the dry spell that hit the region.
Before, people of Karamoja, when there is hunger, they used to go to Teso Sebei, Abim, they used to go to Karenga and some other areas, but right now they can't go there just because of insecurity. You have heard that the neighbors also are being invaded, like the Teso and Sebe, where people used to go to suffer. So you cannot go to the neighborhood.
The consistent insecurity for 3 years has made it difficult for crop farmers, for livestock farmers to do anything. So it's really largely responsible if your cows were stolen, and yet normally our people rely on their cows, their milk, to survive in a year like this when there is no harvest, because milk is, you know, is a complete meal.
Mary Gino, the chairperson Kabong District, says people have started eating grass in the district due to lack of food. He expressed fears that more elderly people are likely to die of starvation because they cannot run to other regions for greener pastures.
The disabled, people living with disabilities, these people are going, because when the young people are going to the centers to survive, they are left behind together with the children, and there's no food. People have resorted to heating some grass, which I only heard that people ate it in 1980 when there was famine in Karamoja. There is a grass called Ewududu, where it is very tiny, and you have to really like the size, almost millet, but also tinier than millet. You have to scratch, harvest a lot, scratch, but in the end you get a little bit and grind it into porridge. That's what people are feeding on, something which has never been heard of in Uganda. And interestingly, this country is a blessed country. Don't know God just put it here and put it as Ugandans. But in this 21st century, we are witnessing this happening in Karamoja, and nobody's talking about it, including the media. Hardly goes to cover such things.
Now these legislators want the government to table a supplementary request in parliament to find funds to rescue the people of Karamoja with adequate relief aid.
A family was given 2 cups of beans and a small container, a nomi container of posho. That is just a meal for a day. What about tomorrow? What about the next day? It means that you're going to eat today. The next day probably you would have some calories to move for that day. But the third day, you go back to zero.
Report by Fred Kajui for the news at Parliament.